Hello everyone, welcome to this course on IBM Data Stage. My name is Anshul and I'm the instructor of this course. I have 10 plus 6 years of experience in ETL on Data Stage and I'm an Data Stage 11.3 certified and Oracle certified. I have experience of working with clients like banking, healthcare, life science, insurance, telecom and logistics. I have implemented many ETL scenarios and structured data warehouses using ETL Data Stage. So, what is IBM Data Stage? Data Stage is an ETL tool from IBM, which can be used to integrate data from different sources, create new business requirements, and migrate the data from different sources onto the target, which is again a data warehouse. So, while we do this, we need to connect to different source systems, like it may be sequential file, or it may be a database, which is DB2. Cloud, Oracle, or any source systems, and IBM Data Stage is flexible and has huge amount of connectivity options with all these different source systems to fetch and load the data, and because of that, it is one of the leading ETL tool in the market currently. Having the flexibility of using C++ code in Data Stage gives us the option of using the complex transformation and implementing those from the business requirement. Meaning, if at all we got a complex requirement which is very, very complex and we are not able to implement it, we can do that using C++ coding through transformer, which supports C++ encapsulation. It is useful in processing and transforming large amount of data because of its partitioning and pipelining and scalable parallelism concepts. It has huge connectivity to all the different databases, enterprise applications, and cloud-based computations like Azure, AWS, Salesforce, etc. So, what are we going to cover in this course? We will start with understanding the architecture of Data Stage and how the Data Stage has been divided. All the components of Data Stage software has been divided so that they can be installed on one or more servers. How from a client application or a client server, I can connect to Data Stage server. Then we will look at the installation piece. How an administrator can install Data Stage and what are the deployment topologies that is available, which can be used based on the business scenarios, based on the availability of the servers to install Data Stage. Precisely, the deployment topologies are 2-tier, 3-tier, cluster, and grid. So we'll be looking into all these four different deployment topologies. We will also be looking into some of the very important concepts of partitioning and pipelining. And then we will be setting up the administrators, like Data Stage administrator and web console. We'll be doing this necessary setup in these two, like creation of project, creation of users, creation of groups, assigning users to groups, assigning roles to these users for the specific project. So all these things we'll be looking into in the administration section. Thereafter, we will go ahead and start designing Data Stage job in Data Stage Designer and checking the logs in Data Stage Director. We will see where we can use Data Stage Director, how we can schedule a job, or how we can execute or restart a job which got aborted, how we can look at the logs from the Data Stage Director. We'll also look at what are the different significant stages in Data Stage Designer, which we can use to design our different requirements. It will be initially with stage oriented, where we will try to understand the stages, the different options that it has, and try to develop certain requirement. And slowly it will be requirement oriented. Reason is, initially, if we go ahead with requirement and orientation, for designing Data Stage job, it will be very difficult because we do not know about the stages that is available in Data Stage. Once we get familiar with the stages, we can bring in the requirement and place them or structure them in the course. So that is why initially it is the stage orientation in terms of learning, and thereafter it is requirement orientation in terms of learning. Then we'll also look at runtime column propagation and parallel and sequencer jobs. So we'll look at runtime column propagation because this runtime column propagation, named as RCP, is the one which helps any developer to design a generic job, which can be used to implement the similar requirement for n number of different jobs. So generic job we can use implement through runtime call application. We'll also look at how we can import and export attested jobs, how we can promote jobs from one environment to another environment using importing and exporting of jobs. What are the designing standards? What are the performance tuning tips? Also, we'll look at how we can find a job which we have created today and we want to find it out, say, next week or so, if we do not know the names. We'll also look at if we want to find any specific table modifications, like if I designed a tested job and the entire team has been designing it for last year or so, and the target table structure or the source table structure has metadata of that has been changed. So how to find out what are the jobs which has been using these stages, these metadata. So we will see how we can find that option and find the stages, and we can go ahead with that. So these are some of the options that we are going to cover in the course, along with the practical scenarios and huge number of assignments. There are many more to go, not just these. We will look into them slowly as we go through in the course. So who all will get benefited to the course? Well, the course has been designed from a fresher level to an experienced level to learn from this. There is something new for everyone from all the experience level in the course. For a fresher, it is starting from the very base level, and so it will be very useful for them to start, understand, and learn. Those who have already certain experience on data stage will still find that the course is useful for them, as the course has significant in-depth details of each and every stage, in-depth detail of each and every options, and the performance tuning tips. If at all you have experience in any other ETL tool and you want to learn data stage because of its market demand or opportunities, yes, you will definitely find that this course is useful for you, and you will be able to correlate the course content and whatever you have learned in ETL. So the course is designed in that way that you will be able to correlate them. So precisely, this course is for everyone, from a fresher level to an experienced level, and if you have experiences in different levels, different tools as well, so you will get benefited from this course. Now, what are the advantages of this course? Well, learning at your own pace with your time and flexibility without the hassle of depending on someone else, which is your instructor, or maybe the consultancies which are pitching in between middle to kind of correlate the training. The best part is the course is being trained by an instructor who has more than 3 years of experience training the course in-house, in the company, and as a corporate trainer or online trainer or classroom trainer. So I have all the experience of working as an online trainer, corporate trainer, or training in the same company which I was working on. I have done that data stage training in that company as well, and also the classroom trainer. So because of this versatile experiences that I have got with different situations, I was able to bring in this course so that it can help all the different categories of people who want to learn data stage. The added benefit that I find with this course is the videos are available at my own disgrace, and I can use it, I can repeat it as and when I want. So if I am not clear about any concept, I can reiterate the video, I can re-look into the video. The videos sizes are more. We may find that the size of the video is like an hour or so, or sometime 40-50 minutes, but that is precisely the in order to keep the continuation of the tool. Continuation. So if we do not have the continuation, if we are trying to do some logic implementation or some stage we are trying to learn, and we disconnect in the middle between the videos, so we will lose the track. So in order to maintain that, the videos has been designed, though it will be a little lengthy, but it is just to ensure that we start a topic and we cover the topic end to end with looking at each and every option that is available. Additionally, with these online available videos, you will have lifetime access to the video and the content and the assignments. And in case of any clarifications, you can use the discussion forum as well, and me and many other students who are learning from this course will be there to help you out in that. With this, let's start the course, and welcome to the course on IBM Data Stage.